Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 110 of the Realm Recap. I'm Jason from YakFace.com. Joined once again from forever ago is FlyGuy from FlyGuy.net.
Hello, 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 hello. Yes, it's been a while since we did this. It was February, wasn't it? It was Toy Fair,
Yep.
And then we planned to do one before Celebration, but then, you know, life.
Life stuff. Happens.
Kids, yep. Jobs, all that stuff. But we're back.
But we're back.
Post-celebration.
Lots of stuff happened between our last show and now. We'll just touch on, you know, some of the more important stuff that came out, you know, from Celebration on. We won't try to revisit history with some of that stuff. But yeah, Celebration was, if you were there, you had one of two experiences, a good one or a bad one, I guess. You were either in a queue or in some sort of line waiting for something you might not have really needed to wait for, or you skipped all that nonsense and just kind of took it all in and, you know, bounced from place to place. I had the cheap seats and I watched the live stream from home, which was kind of shaky at the beginning. I don't know if you've heard anything about how it started out, but it was bad when the live stream started with the first, you know, what was it, the 40th anniversary panel? I think the audio was out of sync with the video, so it was really bad. And then they would, like, if they were talking about something being shown on a screen at one point, the camera wouldn't cut away to show what they were talking about, so you see a lot of people go, oh god, that's awesome. It's like, oh, you can't see it.
It was definitely weird. A little odd, but hey, we got live streams. I think that's one of the challenges. I tried to do some live streams as well, and people were like, oh, the quality's terrible. And it's like, it's kind of live from a phone. I mean, you know, and it's data, and trying to get data out that hole was terrible. The kind of shielding on it was really tough, so getting signals out wasn't great. So
yeah, with everyone else trying to log up bandwidth. I mean, because I watched a few of the ones that you had done where you gave, like, the floor tour, you know, before the floor opened, you know, you popped around from to the different booths, and that was great to see that stuff before before it got, you know, open to the public, obviously. But yeah, it's a convention. It's what, you know, half the experience is actually going, the other half is hanging out with your friends and other stuff. And I guess if you were to split it up into thirds, is the third part is, you know, you being broke after the whole thing is done, which I'm finding out relatively quickly since I'm picking up a lot of the convention exclusives that I missed out on not getting, mainly the Funko Pop ones, since Hasbro only had the one. I'm not going whole hog and buying the actual convention exclusive pops. I'm going with the retailer shared exclusive ones, which is obviously a lot more economical and
I
don't care about the sticker. So
yeah, no, it's just a sticker.
Yeah,
but some people go nuts for it. But it was a good con. It was a good con. It was very busy, as you see. It was definitely, it's a lot of lines, a lot of frustrated people with tops. Mm-hmm. Getting signatures was really a bit of a pain. I think Cody's either already covered it or we certainly
spoke about
it. It wasn't quite as slick. Paying that VIP wasn't quite as slick as it should have been. But there's always downsides to cons. And as you said, it's a giant hall with a lot of people in it.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty much it. So the rest is just what you make it and what vendors make it. But
yeah.
I should say very quickly, shout out to everybody who stopped by. And I saw a load of people who would say to me, oh, you're here. Oh, my God. I don't think I've seen you watching the Realm Recap. Where's Jason? And I'm like, you're not attached to me. We are separate. We are two separate people. But they were really nice. So many people were asking me, and it was the next thing they came at the mouth was, where's Jason? So a lot of people were looking for you, looking for us. So, and Sinister Six, thank you to the Philadelphia Collectors Club. They gave me a t-shirt here. You didn't get one, so
nah.
So this is the real convention exclusive, buddy.
Nice.
So I'm sure we've got one for you. But nice people. Really nice, meeting a lot of nice people. For long to...
Let me froze up a little bit. He'll be back. Seems to be. Oh, right. Here he comes. He's coming back.
Oh,
there you go.
Still right there. But yes, so it's all about the people. at the cons. That's the good thing.
Yep. That's what I miss the most, is being able to go and hang out with everyone. Mm-hmm. I mean, everyone was, I mean, privately, people were all sharing pictures, you know, Corey and the guys were all, you know, Chris, it was cool to see, and it would have been great to be there, but I got to live vicariously through everyone, through their
good way to do it.
Systems and watching live with a lot of other people. So it was fun.
It was fun.
So what should we start with? Should we start with some of the Hasbro exclusive stuff that was brought up, or where do you want to go?
We'll get the Forces of Destiny first. Okay. Which was kind of, might as well just share it. Let me bring that up on screen.
Now, the Forces of Destiny thing was, the name itself was shared a few months back. I reported it through, the United States Trademark Office that had posted that trademark, like I said, a couple months back. And there was speculation, people thought it might have been a game, or, for a while, oh, could that be the title of, episode 8 or something like that? But no, privately, secretly, I knew what it was for, shortly after that name was announced, but we officially get the reveal here. Is it's, I don't want to say it's a girl targeted line, but essentially that is what it is.
But we did get a Luke as well. There's a Luke coming.
Right.
There's Yoda, which we think is a boy. I guess. There was another one as well. I can't remember who it was. Can't recall. But those droids, you're right, we were talking about this earlier on, they look super tiny.
Yeah.
R2's really small. Maybe they've used another scale and another figure, but...
Yeah, it's interesting to see. Obviously the focus is on the main characters themselves. I think the Yoda and the R2 and the BB-8 are kind of ancillary background type characters for the storyline. Which is what I think is really cool, is they, because basically what this is it's a tie-in to these little shorts that are going to run, mm-hmm. an animated 2D animation series that's going to start, where it focuses on Jin, Rey, Sabine,
Ahsoka,
Hera, Ahsoka. Yep. And it spans the saga that we know of so far. So it's, ties in Rebels, it ties in with the original trilogy, and obviously this, the sequel trilogy with Rey. So it's pretty cool. It's very similar to what Mattel had done with their girl figures. I can't remember what they're called at the moment.
Oh, the DC ones you're talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah. They did arrange that with Harley and others. Yeah, I saw that. Yep. I saw that. Kind of cool.
But these are 12-inch figures. They're articulated. They have different outfits that some of them come with. I think there's a Leia that has like the Endor gear, as well as her Ewok dress that you could switch out. And
yep,
it's kind of cool. I think my kids, I have four girls, and two of them which are old enough to want things like this. They saw them and they thought they were great. So guess who's buying these?
I know. Well, I think the thing that it struck me was it was very similar to, it's a very similar style. And I really like it, actually, when they do that, like the Genndy Tartakovsky minisodes, the little tiny minisodes. There's 16 episodes planned in this series. And I think they could be really cool. They could be really interesting. Sometimes when they've got those limits of time and they've got to keep it quick, you get some cool stuff. I mean, we got that kind of awesome Wampa Arc fighter, the whatever it was, can't remember the exact name.
Yeah, the Arc.
It's Arc Starfighter, whatever. But we got the first look at General Grievous with that kind of crazy jumping all over the place.
Yep.
So there's some really cool things that can come out of these mini-sodes, I think. So yeah, it could be cool. Could be really cool.
Yep. Looking forward to that.
What else do we have? And they've got comic books for that as well. We can't show this video for number 2.
Right.
Because YouTube will have a fit. But Vintage Collection.
Yep. They announced during the Hasbro's panel that in 2018, next year, that they're relaunching the vintage collection, which is fitting because that's technically the 40th anniversary of the action figure line for Kenner because of, you know, the action figures didn't come out in 1977 for Kenner. They came out a year later. So that makes perfect sense.
Yep.
I'm ecstatic about it. I think it's great. I love the format of the 3¾-inch line, especially on the vintage cards. So,
yep. It was pretty amazing. They did this, and we can't play the video because YouTube just doesn't like when we play other videos in a video. But you can watch it online if you want. I recorded the little, very emotional little kind of couple of minutes there. You had to be in the room. Steve Evans was literally in tears. He had a couple of man tears, manly toy tears. Just about how they can, once you're in that music and the themes and you're there and you're all a bunch of toy nerds, it kind of gets you. You have to, you'll see what I mean. But
you're 5 years old all over
exactly,
again.
Exactly. And so they did this really nice buildup of key moments from the movies, moments as Steve Evans called it. And then they referred it to some of the vintage figures, Tusken Raider and Boba and others. And then they showed some of the vintage figures as well. And then the big reveal was, and it's a little hard to show it here, but the package spins round and there's Rey in The Force Awakens in the vintage card back. And you'll audibly hear me and a couple of other guys just woo and kind of scream and all this kind of stuff. So
yep,
it's good to have it back. But I think as I was saying the other day in another show, it then hit me that it's a whole other line we have to start buying again for some of us. I'd kind of given up in 3.75 and I'm
like, right, oh right. God. So
yes, the ecstatic was met with the God, where am I gonna put this?
It's gonna be a busy couple years of action figure collecting if you really think about it. I mean, it's like vintage collection coming back. You've got a Han Solo movie coming out, you've got episode 9, obviously, or 8, excuse me. It's gonna be full. I mean, with 6-inch scale, you're gonna have the basic the 3.75 kind of universe collection, which is the 5POA type figures. Mm-hmm. And then this, and this is not exclusive to any retailer. It's going to be a mainline release again, like how it was mm-hmm. before. Yeah, it's going to be spendy for people, I think. If you're really into the action figure collecting and, you know, if you're one of everything type of collector, you're really going to be committed this year, I guess.
I have my feeling the price is going to be up around the $16, kind of $16 mark. There's no way they can do, I mean, what was it? Walmart was $12.82 for the current vintage figures, which were mostly repacks, if you can find them. Well, I mean, it's funny enough, there's a lot of them online. If you look at Amazon, others I just posted the other day, there's tons of Ahsokas. I mean, Amazon can't give them away. Free shipping and $11 for Ahsoka vintage collection. Not on the vintage collection card, but right, in that Black Series pack. So, yeah, they're there. But, yeah, I can't see the line. I can't see them being able to sustain the line with all the high articulation and the paint and the card for less than $15, $14.99, maybe something like that.
Yeah.
It's spendy. It's a little spendy. But,
but this is what people want.
Yeah,
if you subscribe to that thought of, you know, collectors don't want 5POA, you know, some collectors don't, and they want super articulated figures. Well, this, if that's the case, then that's what you're going to have to pay to get them. And if you want them to continue, you have to, you know, open your wallets, I guess.
Yep. I mean, we're going to see a lot of repacks. We'll see probably the Phasma repacked from that Walmart lane. We'll see some of the other articulated figures there. We got a Poe, didn't we, at one point? We got a Finn.
Yep.
There'll be a lot of repacks in that lane again, but that's what has to happen to sustain it. So, yeah, interesting stuff.
Very cool. Back. Let's see. I don't know if we'll get to it here in a bit. The First Order podcast panel.
Yeah, I just wanted to give a little shout out to Cody and the guys, and particularly to Cody, who, if you don't know the First Order podcast, definitely check it out, First Order Pod on Twitter. Cody had, I mean, it was the Oprah panel. It was everybody got a prize, and it wasn't like, you know, you get a little 5POA figure. People were getting Lego Falcons, and, you know, it was ridiculous. ridiculously good. He bought a lot of the prizes. Some were from sponsors. Dark Side Toys had some, and a few other sponsors that had given him some of the toys there for the giveaway. But there was Disney Elite. There was Black Series packs. There was it was so generous of him. So big shout to him.
Yep.
And I got to be on the panel with those and the Bill and Marco and all the other guys. So you were there in spirit, sir. You were there in spirit.
And what's funny is Corey originally brought up the idea of, oh, we should do a podcast panel. And I was kind of like, I was kind of apprehensive at the beginning. It's like, do we really want to do this? You know, are we going to commit our time and are we really going to do it? And I mean, I'm so glad that, I mean, someone who's well younger than I am, grabbed the bull by the horns and said, no, I'm going to freaking do this. And he did it. Exactly. And like you said, he was super generous and, you know, we set up a lot of great, giveaways and stuff. So yeah, I mean, it was very cool. And I think it was a pretty successful little panel. So.
It was a really good quiz and fun kind of panel. Everybody got something. Some people got two prizes, but not only just because of the prizes, but it turned out a lot slicker than the first one we'd done at Anaheim. We were a little bit new to all this, but this time it was really well done. So congratulations to him and the other dudes on the panel.
Yep, and it was a good time slot too, because it was like right at the end of everything. So, you know, people who were, you know, one of their last events of the convention, they got to come and watch and they left with something, or, you know, more than one item, like you said. So yeah, it was very cool. So
it was good fun.
Very nice.
Indeed. So I think next is just a bunch of all the photos, really.
Right. Some exclusives were announced at the Hasbro panel. And also the sale of like the X-Wing Luke 6-inch figure.
That's right. So I grouped together all of the, you got them too, we all got them, the Hasbro official photos and the other ones that I took, decent ones from the show floor, and just went through and I just put them all in a high-res Google photo gallery, but some of them were truly outstanding. The Luke X-Wing coming in two flavors, which is bizarre to say the least.
Oh, the Landspeeder,
Yeah, which, correct me if I'm wrong, so the San Diego Comic-Con version is the full-on this version here.
Right. It has a different deco.
Different deco. That's right.
The Landspeeder itself has some moving parts underneath the hood, apparently.
That's right.
The CDCC exclusive version. Yes, a different paint job. I'm not 100% clear on the accessories that are different between the two. Because some of the shots have the floppy hat and the poncho.
Yep.
And then others don't. I'm guessing most of the, you know, like with the Kylo Ren pack that came out at CDCC last year, you know, it had the banner flag deal and the Vader helmet and and stuff like that. I think, and the Kylo Ren helmet. I think it's going to be a similar type of deal where you don't get the... You don't get the poncho and the floppy hat in the retail exclusive or the retail release.
Yep. I did speak to Steve Evans and asked him, and he did tell me, but either I can't remember. But I did distinctly get the impression that it was two different builds of that Landspeeder. Paint was one without a doubt.
Yep.
Accessories, yes. But he seemed to, as you just said, there seems to be a different part or something different in the SDCC version compared to the regular one, which really confuses me because I've never seen them do that where they've done such different things for vehicles. But anyway, we'll find out in time more. We'll get more details. But yeah, the two versions coming of that one. And the other biggie was a beautiful pack for Thrawn, which was just outstanding.
Yeah, this is one of their coolest exclusives that they've done.
I think so.
It's got the little prizes or, you know, his little display gallery pieces from his office in that episode of Rebels.
Mm. And this was the nice little touch. They said this was the designers putting in the Indiana Jones Grail Cup.
Right.
Grease helmet.
Yeah. That Grail Cup was in that episode too.
Was it? I didn't see it. Ah, nice touch. Well, they've continued it on. A couple of sabers. And the Jedi Temple Guard, which I think really does hint strongly that you're going to get a 6-inch figure at that one point, I would suggest. That little temple guard, the Jedi temple guard down there. So I'm sure one day we'll get that because it was a fan favorite in 3.75, but there's more of the goodies there. But why bother making the mold for the helmet if you're not going to finish off the rest of the figure? So
right.
And there's Hera's little doll-like thing that she had, the little heirloom
that,
thing.
Yeah.
Was it Sabine's? I can't know.
No, Hera's. It was Hera's, yeah.
So very good figure and really nicely presented. That packaging is just
That's really well done.
It's
cool because the graphic that's kind of overlaid on him on that packaging is the bottom of his Star Destroyer.
So it is. Nice. Yes, that's very, very cool. Sweet indeed. And the little snakes there. That's very cool indeed. They've just done a really beautiful job. They were very proud of it, and rightly so.
Yep.
Of course, Rey Speeder, which we saw before the show, that was kind of revealed early. The Battlefront 2 Inferno Squad Trooper, just complete repaint, the designers confirmed to me, so there's nothing new on the figure.
What's interesting about that is that that leaked out like right before it was announced, like the day before. It does have a little bit, it's a little bit different than the first TIE Fighter pilot that came out. It has a different belt. The one that came out originally has kind of just a standard belt with a holster. This one has the Stormtrooper belt with the holster, you know, where it has the little pouches that go around.
There you go. So maybe you just reused the part before then or something.
Yeah. You know, they just recast the Stormtrooper belt. It's hard to see in this photo, but in some of the other press photos on the GameStop site, I think you could see a little bit better the difference.
Yep.
But yeah, this is exclusive to GameStop coming in November.
Yep. And Commander Gree, which is Toys R Us exclusive at $25.
Yep.
Which Hasbro, Steve Evans, went into great kind of design detail about the fact that this had something like 300 paint apps required. Yep. So this became a very expensive figure because of all the paint required to it, which is a really, again, just that other factor there that it's not necessarily about the mold or the accessories.
Yep.
It's all about the paint. The paint is the thing that costs money so much for these figures. That's why we don't get a lot of detail on the faces sometimes. It costs too much money.
Right.
So, but nicely done. Jaina Solo, that was a fan's choice from last year, wasn't it? I think. Or an older choice.
Yeah, that was the winner.
That was the, was that the winner? I thought it was Revan that was the winner. Was it?
No. I think Revan was before. I don't, maybe there was a co-winner. I don't know. I know Rev or Jaina was a winner of something.
Yep. Well, she's nice. I mean, she looks a good figure. Very nice up close. She's definitely, they talked about the kind of length of detail they went to kind of apply a kind of Solo smirk.
Right.
And you can kind of see it. It's, they've done a nice job on it. It's they've kind of captured a lot digitally. They tried to have Carrie and Harrison together and then schmooshed up this this figure, but a lot of nice detail.
And a lot of her gear is removable too. You could take off her flight jacket and or her vest, I guess. It's a really well done figure. I really like it. You know, you don't get a lot of X-Wing figure, or, you know, I guess pilot figures for the Rebellion in some of this Black Series line. So it's really good. There's a ton of detail. I really like this figure so far.
It's really nice. I can see a lot of people. It's EU, exactly. I can see a lot of people swapping this with a purple saber for making a Mata Jade or something out of that in a heartbeat. So there's just some other photos from the booth. Discord Commander, which we is literally out right now. We'll talk about that in a minute. But these, you actually picked these up, didn't you?
No, you I haven't seen them yet.
Oh, okay. I thought you should shoot. Maybe you shoot someone else's photo, but yeah, they didn't look great on the shelf.
No interest.
Yeah, no interest for me either. So these are the titanium 3.75. Lovely backdrops on them on the reverse side, not so much the silver foil side, but on the other side, the kind of movie still parts. They were really nice. And that was the rest of the stuff in the booth. Little close-ups of the Tusken looking fab, which I just found out today pretty much on Twitter. I didn't realize this guy was being reboxed in the black and red.
Yes. All of the vintage carded ones that that are coming out will be in the black and red series box, except for R5-D4. That's the only one that's exclusive to the vintage card back.
See, that's just really annoying though, because that means I'm buying everything like four times. This is just
well, you know, you got Leia, you know, she's on both, and you got Obi-Wan on both, you got Luke on both.
God damn Hasbro. I didn't realize it was the full gamut that were being repackaged on the black and red. I was like, no, these are all like the Death Squad Commander. I thought there's no way he's coming back in the black and red.
Yep. But,
oh, God. Anyway, so some other figures that were on display in the cabinet. We tweeted these out a long, long time ago, but the Royal Guard, which looks fantastic. It's just blown up 3.75. Lando looking very smooth. Really captured his face really well. And that was pretty much, I think we'd seen just about everything else. The Land Speeder did some really nice details on the booth of kind of, they called it From the Vault. It was lots of archive photos and snapshots of the packaging of old and the instruction manuals and stuff like that and prototypes on there. So beautifully presented. They really went to town on it.
Yeah, they had a great display this year.
It was nice. It really, really was nice. And some vintage figures in the booth as well. And they showed you where some of the paint splotches and marks will go on the prototype. And they talked about that and the difference in them. So yeah, it was nice. On shelf, 1st of September.
Yep.
And there's all the people involved.
For Force Friday.
For Force Friday, indeed. And that was it. Thrown in some others. There's the packaging for Luke. That's the regular. That's not the San Diego Comic-Con, or is it?
I think that is the San Diego exclusive packaging.
Okay. I'm not quite sure what the San Diego one is then. See, that's got all these accessories, but the paint looks clean. Oh, never mind. All confusing.
It's very confusing, actually.
It's very, very confusing. And there's the more detail of the working parts and bits and pieces. And a blow up of the sculpt there just shows the detail in the face. So it's very nice. Did a good job Tarkin as well, I should have mentioned there, with Dr. Ball.
Ray and the speeder. That's the one that ships alongside the Luke in Land Speeder.
Yep. And all the nice details they talked about, the little bits and pieces inside the packaging and all the kind of nice touches. They've definitely reused parts of Ray, but a lot of it's nice new fabric and backpacks. And so it's still a nice looking figure.
Flaps that open on the speeder itself. And, you know, both the Land Speeder and Ray's Jakku speeder, they have a nice, you know, clear display stand so you could have them appear to be flying.
Exactly. No, that's a really nice part. I like that. And that was it. The rest of the figures are just from the booth, and then some other just kind of high-res images that we just got from Hasbro for the other figures that are literally heading stores.
Yeah, that's very weird because they said that they weren't coming until June, so that's like a month and change early. So
no.
Reported from, you know, California, Texas, Arizona, Washington here in the U.S. I don't know if they've hit overseas anywhere yet. I think I saw a report on Instagram or something like that, that the you know, the wave that has Qui-Gon and Lando has started showing up.
Singapore.
Yep. So there's going to be a lot of stuff for sale here pretty soon. You know, obviously around the, you know, May is a big month for Star Wars as far as merchandise goes. I think StarWars.com over the weekend has shared an article showing just like tons of places that's going to have exclusive merchandise as far as for the May the 4th sale. You could go to StarWars.com and take the link and check it all out. And, you know, everything from clothes to toys and, you know, a lot of sales and not necessarily a lot of exclusives, but just, you know, they're really pumping up the May the 4th promotion right now. So,
God, they did everything in there from beach balls to socks to jigsaws to, I mean, they covered every base of it. A Star Wars label on it.
Pool toys and
exactly. Like, I mean, you name it, they had it for May the 4th. So, it's a really good roundup and good confirmation that, for example, Target had a discount on some stuff. And there's a few Amazon daily deals that have been cropping up as well. So, we'll try and post that out. So just very quickly, we were talking about Wave 2. Mm-hmm. Wave 1 has just hit on Australian shores. So they're just getting here. Now, they hit the UK literally just as celebration was happening. So, yeah, it's kind of weird. It seems to be a kind of window in my mind. It's like there's a three-month window when it first appears to when it really, if you don't get it in 3 months, chances are it's probably not coming to your country.
Right.
But it takes its time. But it's good to see that these waves are just pretty much globally in every place, I think. So.
Yep.
Yep.
Some of the figures from that first wave are still pretty in demand here. You know, like the Han and the R2, both of them are one per in each case. They're the first ones to go, and they're still way, you know, as far as from eBay prices, they still command a pretty decent price. So it seems like every retailer under the sun is offering the figures, though. I mean, from Target, Walmart, Toys R Us, Best Buy, Meijer, Walgreens, you know, just you're going to be able to find them eventually. It's just getting them out there in any sort of quantity is what's really been the issue.
Yeah. Yeah. But I guess it's frustrating. A lot of people are seeing the wave two turn up and they've not even got their wave ones or so.
Right.
Yeah, it's always frustrating. It's always hell with Hasbro trying to get their stuff. It really is sometimes, but you posted as well, we should mention Luke X-Wing, the Hasbro Toy Shop. It was up and then it was going in about what, 20 minutes or something?
Yeah. About 30 minutes is what I kind of experienced. I had been tweeting along throughout the day of when it went up. It lasted about 30 minutes and it goes, it's, you know, six one, half dozen the other. It could either go up at 5 a.m. Eastern time, or it can go up at 2 o'clock Eastern time. You know, it's like any time they put it up, some segment of, at least from the U.S. standpoint, is going to get burned on there when they're available to be online. And I was fortunate. I'm fortunate enough to be able to be online all day long while I work. So I was able to score mine like right away and, you know, get it out there that it was available. So, that was cool. So, but yeah,
that's good.
People do keep asking if it's going to go back up online though. And I wouldn't bet on it.
I wouldn't think so. And to be fair, I don't know what your thoughts are on it. I've not reviewed it or done anything yet, but I mean, it's the same figure on a shiny card.
The sculpt is the same. The deco of the figure itself is different,
slightly different. Yeah,
than the first release. So
it is.
It looks better, in my opinion. I'd have to really get them side by side and really scrutinize the differences. I mean, just from my mind's eye, looking at the new figure in hand, I think the difference is negligible.
Oh, absolutely. It seems to me more like a kind of black wash on the jumpsuit. Yeah. And that's it.
The lines look a little bit better on the helmet. You know, it's kind of a little bit cleaner of a deco, but overall it's the same figure. And I wouldn't be, if you're a vintage collector or if you're a vintage carded collector, I can see the desire and understand the want to get this version. But it's also, you know, it's the oddball of the 40th anniversary 6-inch figures too, because it's on the foil card and it doesn't match any of the other ones. It's like, God,
could you make it matte, please? I know. It's just, I don't know why they felt the need to do
the foil,
reflective foil. It's just, I don't know. It kind of sucks in my mind that way, but there we go. We got it. So, I absolutely cannot see them passing up on doing more vintage carded figures in the future. They will.
I think they did say that they weren't going past the ones that have been announced.
You give it a couple of years, 2 or 3 years time or something. They'll come out with Ponda Baba and Boba Fett and all those. Yeah.
I think that when the 40th anniversary of Empire rolls out, they'll dip back in.
Yep, I think so.
And we're going to get like a Bespin Han, and we're going to get like a Boba Fett, and, you know, we're going to...
Boba Fett.
Yeah, they're really going to, you know, throw the salt on the open wound, and I wouldn't put it past them at all, and I'm totally cool with it. You don't have to make every one. Just make a strong selection of figures represented, you know, goddamn, give me a Yoda on that card back, and I'll be in heaven, essentially. So,
I mean, they literally could just do nothing but churn out that line now on these cards,
right?
And you know, instant guaranteed sales. But I think, like the vintage collection, they're going to do that kind of thing where periodically dipping in and out of these things is probably good for us all to not overdose and get to number 96 and then go, well, what do we do now? So it's better to keep it kind of sporadic. But
right, it's like you don't need a, you know, Bespin security guard on, you know, 6-inch on a vintage card. You know, they stick with the mainline characters. You know, give us the Snow Trooper on the vintage card back. You know, they can stick with characters that they've done and sprinkle in a couple new sculpts, obviously. You know, give us a Bespin Luke, Snowspeeder, or Snow Trooper, Yoda. I don't know. Give us Bespin Leia on that card back.
Well, I think it also makes sense for them if they're bringing Lando out in a black and red card. Yep. 2 years' time to get to reuse that mold.
Right.
You get people to buy the same thing all over again for a bit of cardboard. In a financial sense, I mean, it's a business, let's face it. Yeah. It makes perfect sense. Repackage the boba that they made before, repackage some others, and blah, blah, blah. And, you know.
I'm all for it.
Money for old rope. I know. Shut up and take my money.
Right.
Anyway, enough of our OCD collecting craziness. Talking of these 6-inch figures, though, I don't know whether you've seen this. The number, where are we? Number 7 in the list. Have you seen this little commercial, this little stop motion that Hasbro made?
I don't think so.
So they just hats up to Matthew Dillis, who shared with us this morning. There's I can't play it because it's a YouTube video, but it's a stop motion animation officially on Hasbro's channel. Okay. And it's the 12 original vintage figures have a bit of a battle with the 12 Black Series figures. And it's pretty good fun. It's really quite well done. The again, I won't play it. I'll just show you some kind of screen caps here. But some nice little touches and moments where, you know, the vintage Kenner Palitoy figures, whatever, meet the new versions and just kind of freak it a little bit. Luke gets his tiny lightsaber out and Darth get the big saber out, and the little Jawa helps the big Jawa, and little Chewie helps beat up the other fix. So there's a nice little touch here. It's about 2 minutes long, no dialogue or anything, but it's very beautifully done. And what a beautiful display to have the 12 6-inch and the 12 vintage figures as well there. So
now, do they have the vinyl cape Jawa in that shot, or is it the regular?
There's a good question.
I didn't see the vintage Jawa in there.
Look again. I can't play it because
right.
No, I don't think so. I think it's cloth. I think it's cloth. Remember? Yeah, that would be. I mean, there's another exclusive Hasbro could do. It's just,
you know, do a Luke. They should have had the Luke come with the yellow lightsaber instead of the blue one. Even though it's completely wrong, but it just would have been. Make that the exclusive. Farm boy Luke with the yellow lightsaber.
You and I talked about this ages ago. We kind of saw something on a Gentle Giant video one night, and the two of us kind of shat our pants. I think we were kind of like,
that was
12-inch versions of the, 6-inch versions of the original figures. So like the 5POE stuff and the lightsaber. We'd buy them all over again.
I remember seeing that Boba Fett in that video.
I think they make them obviously at different scales to blow them up, and I think we just got a little too
proof of concept type of thing.
But yeah, that was that one. So I thought it was worth sharing. So thank you to Matthew Dillis for sharing that with me.
Let's see, what else is there? The next thing up is R5D4, which is exclusive to GameStop.
And yours turned up in good nick.
Oh yeah. I was very happy with the condition of mine. The card back is, I think, to be honest, it's better than any of the other ones that I have. And it came in a box with no packing material. It's no creases or it's just, it's got that damn sticker though. And I want it. The OCD part of me wants to peel it off, but then the OCD part of me wants to leave it on.
Yeah,
internal battle.
No, it's a fugly sticker. That is a terrible sticker. But yeah, a few people have had them crushed. Score from Tulsa shared a couple of pictures, and I saw some other people and just in the box with nothing. It was just chucked in the box, and so yeah, a lot of these stores, they just, you should know by now. GameStop, Amazon, Hasbro Toy Shop, you're gambling. You have no idea whether you're going to get anything in good condition. So good luck on that one. But
GameStop is supposed to be getting more of them for May the 4th. So I would check your local store if you have one. They're supposed to
good to
be
know.
restocking because of the, and I think it's 20% off that day with GameStop. Like I said, we mentioned before that StarWars.com has a list of all these participating retailers and whatnot having their May the 4th sales. And I think it's 40% off, or not 40, but a 20% off everything Star Wars related at GameStop, whether it be action figures or pops, or I don't know if games are included. I would assume so, but I would check them out if you're looking for that R5D4 on that day. Get there early though.
So I think the next thing is their fans' choice poll.
Oh yeah, that
Number nine.
cluster F.
Yeah.
It's like,
I'll let you have a rant because you had a good stance on this.
yeah, I have no, I mean, despite Yak Face being on there and he's doing very poorly on the poll as of now, there was a lot of back and forth about Ben Skywalker being inserted onto the list via certain sites. They decided to count that. It's tough for me to really complain at all. I mean, there have been so many figures made of some of these characters that are on this list.
Exactly.
Why not? I mean, if Ben Skywalker was on here, I wouldn't care. I disqualified most of the votes regarding him because of how we interpreted the rules. I mean, if you submitted more than one vote for him via the same email address, they didn't count because you're obviously trying to cheat the system. Yeah, it was different people applied the rules differently, and it's a toy for Christ's sake. You know, it's just like,
I know.
it's tough. Again, it's tough for me to get worked up about these altogether, but I do try to adhere to the rules that were set forth by Hasbro when they brought the poll back. So, it was cool. It's cool to have Yak Face on there. I mean, he's been a well desired figure since they've brought these polls back. Just because we've got the Power of the Force version back in what, 98, 97, I can't
And
remember
he's never
exactly
done
when.
anything else.
And it hasn't been revisited. There's a few on there. I mean, Ahsoka's on the list. She's had a lot of figures recently, from the 6-inch version to the 3 3/4 inch, 5 POA version to the Black Series 3 3/4 inch version. Plus, she already has a vintage carded one that came out on the Clone Wars card. I think, I don't know.
I know. I think the thing that got me was, and I'm just sharing the window here again, just to give you an idea of the kind of, I mean, you took this a couple of days ago, but it's up on StarWars.com, the different votes. And it seems like Dr. Aphra is the kind of one there. But I had a conversation with somebody this morning and he was kind of tweeting out, I think it was to you, myself, and Rebel Scum, and, join the campaign. And I was like, why do you have to bloody campaign? It's just a toy. Just make a vote. It's this, it's like we've either got to be right or left these days. There's no in between. Nobody can just say what they like. It's you got to be one or the other, or you're just, you're gonna die. It's just, oh, it's just, I don't know. I just find it frustrating that something simple turns into just such a bloody drama. But
Yeah, currently I'm on StarWars.com right now on my phone and looking at the standings, and Yak Face is square in the middle. It's
there you
third from
go.
the bottom and third from the top.
So, Dr. Aphra still up the top.
Dr. Aphra is still at, she's at 30%. Ahsoka's at 28. Oh, I'm not in the middle. I'm actually second from the bottom. I Yak Face is second from the bottom. ARC Trooper Fives is at 12%. Yak Face is at 10, and Sim Alu is at 6.
as he should be. I don't even know why he's in this. Who wants Simalou? Seriously?
It's really for those. I get the pick only because it hasn't had a modern interpretation since, you know, 95. It's the only figure of him that exists is the one that came out in 85. So I get the draw to have some sort of a modern version. It's a boring figure, but
he's an ass boring figure.
I mean, I'm not saying that Yak-Face is a, you know, must have action figure in that scale. Again, it holds a special place for a few reasons, because it was so hard of a figure to get originally.
Sure.
You know, there's been, you know, but Gentle Giant has done their versions. Hasbro did their one, like I said, back in the 90s. It'd be cool to have another version that's kind of a modern definitive version.
Oh, I find that the similar, I mean, not even a speaking part, just, I know, it's just, it's a dude with curtains on. It's just really so boring. I know, I get it too. It's not, you know, it needs an update, but does it? I don't know. Anyway, it's a fan's choice, so
yeah.
Get out there and vote.
Yeah, so. Vote for who you want. I don't care. I voted my conscience. You do the same.
Exactly.
What's next?
Titanium
3.75. These have started showing up. I think the first places that really started to get them was GameStop again here in the US. They've started popping up at I'm not sure if Target is. I read so many store reports, I can't remember if Target or Walmart has started receiving them, but they're out there. I mean, for $15 for a die-cast metal figure, it's not the greatest of value.
No.
But you know, from a distance, from presentation aspect, they look nice. I mean, they're decent, but if I shared a picture over the weekend that is of a Han Solo that's, you know, has the eye printed on the side of the face. You know, it's just like, come on.
Pretty terrible. Pretty terrible. Disney.
What do we have for Disney? I close my window. Let's see.
This was the stuff that was available at Celebration as well.
Oh, yeah. Star Celebration had kind of advanced offerings for a lot of these exclusives that are showing up in parks starting last week, or I guess the week before. There's a Astromech 4 pack that came out that we leaked a long time ago that's Clone Wars themed.
Mm-hmm. It's beautiful. It's really nice.
Very cool. It's all droid factory compatible, where you could switch the parts and compatible with all the build a droid factory pieces that you could buy at the individual parks. Then there's they have a couple different carded figures. Chopper is one that's amazingly cool because of all of the, it has a ton of articulation, a ton of swappable parts. You can remove the arm, or, you know, the arms that come out of the head, which are articulated. The regular legs come off. You could switch out his middle wheel/foot for the jet booster rocket deal. It's just from the ground up a better version than Hasbro's, which is a great figure of it in and of itself. But this is like the ultimate version.
It is. And the card back was beautiful too.
Yep. Comes on its own card back. There's an R2-D2 and C-3PO 2-pack carded as well. Again, both figures are really nice, super articulated, both figures. Both are heavily weathered.
Yep.
And it's nice there's set. What's really the last one was the R3-DO Astromech, the red Astromech that we leaked out a few months ago. We weren't quite sure what the status of that figure was going to be. We knew it was going to be a droid factory type of figure, but we didn't know how it was going to be released. And then lo and behold, a couple weeks ago, Disney announced that they were going to have a protocol droid build a figure feature at their parks. So now you could build Astromechs or protocol droids, and there's a ton to choose from. There's like, I can't remember how many. I think there's 70 different new parts for the Astromech line, or for the protocol droid line.
Jeez.
So
that's a lot.
Yeah. And it's not just C-3PO type protocol droids. There's like the Death Star droid type, and there's a Forlom Astromech, and then one from the Clone Wars. I'm not sure what its designation is. It's got a weird kind of bender head from Futurama.
Nice.
Ton of parts, ton of decos.
Cool.
And a ton of money if you're going to buy them all.
Yeah, that's for sure.
What else do we have?
I think it was named Tangential Giant, I think.
Yep, a few different things. Gentle Giant had some cool exclusives for Celebration. One was a Han Solo concept minibus that they had. I'm not sure if you saw it. It's pretty cool. I like it.
No, I don't think I did, no.
They had that. And
oh, I did. The original McQuarrie one. Yes. Sorry, my apologies.
And then they had the Dianoga Jumbo Kenner figure, which is very cool. I have one right here, as you can see in the photo that you're sharing online right now. I did buy it because it was so ridiculous that I had to have it. It comes in a nice giant box like this. I'm going to show it. Do this. Box is huge. That's what she said. It's this. It comes, the figure itself comes carded on its own bubble blister with all of his trash. You know, you can kind of see the green of the trash monster inside there. Full card back with the releases they've had so far, plus all of the, you know, the checklist. Sorry for the glare. One, I just opened this like right before the show, and Gentle Giant, you piss me off because you spelled Dianoga wrong on the nameplate. It says Dianogo.
It's its sister or brother. Yeah.
Dianogo. No go. It's bad. I want some sort of compensation for this.
What's a sticker? Needs a sticker.
Some, you know, issue a sticker or issue a new card back and send it out to the people that bought this, because that's, I'd get some serious ass reaming if I was at work and I made that typo on a printed piece. I work in advertising and marketing. Yeah, we need some sort of rectification of that, because that's not good.
I know. The fact to put it on the outside box and then the inside package, you get it wrong.
Right. It's right there on the box. It says Dianoga. It's like, where, I don't know. Did they have different people working on it, or?
Outside team and the inside team. Yeah, I know.
It's heartbreaking. But anyway, guess I'll have to keep it in the box, because the box is right. Can't have it hanging on my wall with a typo.
The wrong spelling. Oh, geez.
But it is a very cool item anyway. I mean, sure, you're paying for a bunch of foam trash inside of a blister card, but it's got the cool the trash monster in there that came in the Death Star playset.
Well, I think if you're a vintage person as well, you'll remember that that's what came with the Death Star, with bits of foam.
Right.
So it takes you back to that. But yeah, the Gentle Giant booth was busy. There was a lot of people getting very annoyed they couldn't get some of the exclusives. So
yeah, they had some good stuff this year. Yeah.
Hmm.
What else do we have? We have, what is this? Hot Toys. Hot Toys. Yes. A couple days ago, they sent out a newsletter or email blast to various account people that if you buy some of these prepackaged two packs of troopers from The Force Awakens, the Hot Toys versions, you got a free third figure. So, like, you could buy the Snowtrooper and the Snowtrooper Sergeant, or whatever the rank is, Captain. And then you got a free Phasma, which, I mean, It's obviously showing the picture online. It's a $250 figure for free. So exactly. That tells me they're sitting on a shit ton of Hot Toys figures.
Yeah, they are. But I mean, when did you last see buy two Hot Toys, get one free?
Right.
Jesus.
Yeah.
I think that for me, I think having reviewed all of these figures, I think the problems they had were the design of the suits underneath, and they look great, but they're sadly, when you get them, the wrinkles in the armors and the way that it's so much crap under the armor, you can't really pose them. And it's just some of these poses they show, you really can't do in the figure. That they're really quite hard to get in that kind of pose, but it's a shame. They look awesome, and still, buy two get one free. It's not a bad deal if you've been sitting in the fence. So, yeah, good.
Yeah, I think they have four or five different, or three or four different packages that you could do. You know, you could get the Finn with the $21.99 clone trooper, and get the heavy assault trooper for free. Again, some of the standard clones, like the Jakku clone. Stormtrooper and standard Stormtrooper. So a bunch of different ones to pick from, I guess.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Buy two, get one free on Hot Toys. Oh my God. What a time we're living in.
Imagine if they did that with like Iron Man. You buy two Iron Man figures and you get an Iron Man free.
I think it's coming. There's so many armors just don't sell, but there we go.
It's crazy. Moving on to Lego. It's not here in the show notes, but Celebration did have an exclusive at the convention. I've seen it going for ridiculous prices on eBay for a set that includes, I think, no new parts. It's all previously released pieces.
Yep, for the detention block. Yep. I tried to get it, but the line to get in there was just.
Those are always one of the most popular convention exclusives to track down. Lego.
But this set turned up recently. I had not seen this before. This new Starfighter.
Yep, this is the Jedi Starfighter from Episode 2. This is I don't see it marked on here, but is this their UCS set?
It is UCS. There's other shorts that have it as UCS. Okay. Yes, it is a big technical set. So
it's got the Jedi Starfighter with the hyperspace ring. It includes Jango, Boba Fett, Obi-Wan, and who's that? R4-G9?
That'll be, it's Boba's, sorry, not Boba's, Obi-Wan's droid. Yep. So it's a lot of technic stuff in there. It's a big, big set. But yeah, there's other photos floating around. But yeah, it's I believed it was to be announced on May the 4th, but it just kind of got leaked out. So, But yes, so that was Lego.
Yeah. I think I saw, was it on, it might have been over the weekend, yesterday or the day before. I think Rebel Scum was reporting that there's a new Millennium Falcon coming out.
It's been rumored for a long, long time, but I guess if it goes for such crazy money, they've just decided to bring another one out. So I don't know whether it'll be like the Death Star or some of that Hoth stuff where they repackage the same thing and tweak it slightly, or I'm guessing it will be. But yeah, the original one just goes for just loopy money, crazy money. So.
Let's see, what do we have? Next is Funko. Funko had a ton of exclusives over the Celebration event. A lot of the items that they had were shared exclusives where if you couldn't make it to the convention or find someone that could purchase the exclusives for you, you could pick them up through other retailers here in the U.S. and obviously in Australia where you are. The hardest one so far really for me to track down has been the Jedi Luke. It hasn't really gone up for sale. I don't think at all that's a shared exclusive with GameStop. Like all the other ones, like there's the Rey that comes with the speeder. That's an exclusive to Walmart. It last week it popped up online through walmart.com a few times. I was unavoidably detained in some of those instances when it popped up online, so I wasn't able to secure one. So what else is there? There's a Garandam that's exclusive to Walgreens. There is a Clone Trooper that's exclusive to FYE. There was the Thrawn exclusive to Toys R Us. Qui-Gon Jinn exclusive to Target. That's the holographic one. I think there's another one. Oh, there's a Hot Topic Han Solo and Chopper in Imperial Disguise. Yep.
A lot of these seem to have been picked clean already. There's not many stores having them left. So they've really flown off the pegs this year. They've really kind of moved very quickly. So had some nice people. Nate Hawk 76 shared with you and I the that you'd found some Thrawns. And so it's really nice when people share stuff. We can share it out and tell others. But I managed to get in the booth. I managed to get a Funko lottery and got in the very well-organized booth at Celebration. They did a great job. They still do a great job. Better job at marketing, telling people what's out there, where to get it than anybody I know. Here's looking at you, Hasbro. But the booth was fantastic. Really did a good job. Got to meet some of the people who are on the podcast, Funko, Yoko, Cameron and Hillary and a few others. Are all very nice and chatty, and managed to get them all. So, and there's a string of people standing next to the booth. Yep. I'll buy you Qui-Gon. I'll buy you Yoda. I'll give me a pin. I'll give you, there's all sorts of stuff. So it was a lot of people buying and exchanging props. And Funko were not too happy about it. They were really quite annoyed that people were hanging around, but not much they could do.
Yeah.
So just when you went around the... Yeah.
I was going to say, be thankful people are interested in the product and they want it.
Correct. So a lot of people went round the corner from the booth and round, and there was just a huge throng of people buying and trading Funko and pins and all sorts of stuff. So because it was an exclusive Kylo Ren pin you got when you managed to get in the lottery. So some very nice pops. They were very nice, but there's quite a few of them that are quite nice. The Han and the Trooper and a few others. But yes, the Luke and Qui-Gon are definitely in demand for sure.
Our friend Scott from Tulsa has been finding deals as he does. He's like the king of finding great clearance sales. He was sharing a bunch of some of the older pops on clearance at his Walmart down there for like $2 each. So
it's just nuts. That's just absolutely bananas. $2 for these things. So yeah, he always manages to get the deals, but so definitely follow him on Twitter.
So if you're looking for a gateway, you know,
drug
way to get in for minimal investment, you know, $2 pops is probably the way to go.
Exactly. Cool. We're on to you. It's all the stuff you're making.
Oh my gosh. It's been a kind of busy couple of weeks here. Ever since we'll start with Space Walls. Galactic Trading Post, who's been offering for sale these great Star Wall pieces for their for different scales. They're currently there for the 12 or the 6-inch figure scale. They have these different kits that you can buy where you can get like a 9-piece set of walls from the Death Star hallway. So I kind of pulled the trigger and purchased those. They're unbelievably awesome. I've seen a lot of people, especially in, people that do toy photography that have purchased these and their displays and dioramas and their photography, a lot of which were featured by Hasbro, in some of their, display there in their booth at Celebration, had a lot of the, Space Walls product in it. So I pulled the trigger on it and picked up the 9-piece set that they offer, as well as a 2-pack of light panels that they have. There's been a lot of discussion going around as far as quality goes, from all, there's several different online retailers that produce diorama type pieces. And these are by far the best ones that are out there. The plat, they're not 3D printed. They're plastic cast pieces. Like this is the light wall. I don't have a light handy to shine through it, but it allows light to pass through, so it could illuminate some great hallway shots. Different different panels, different designs. They're amazing once you get them set up and get it lit properly. It looks like a miniature Death Star hallway. Yeah. In every way. It's just really fantastic that someone like Galactic Trading Post took the initiative to create something like this for collectors.
And it'll look great in photographs and other stuff that you have, as well as a diorama too. So it's a piece. I think I'll probably be getting some, I think.
Yep. And they're going to be doing them in the 3¾-inch scale as well. Nice. So if you're not a 6-inch collector, you have a option to go to for that. I'm not sure what the ETA is on those pieces, but they definitely, and they offer more than this as well. They have like the doorways, you know, that have the slotted.
Nice. Open the blast doors. Close the blast doors. Yes.
Yeah. The blast doors, some rounded corner sections. They've got like some pillar, you know, kind of like, I don't know, I just got other than pillars type of pieces as well. And they also have, if you go on their site, I think it's, I'm blanking at the moment. There's a link from our homepage that will take you to their site, but they have like little props that have like barrels and crates as well that are
nice.
Cast and not 3D printed. They're just, it's an amazing venture that they've taken on, and they've been really successful. So
excellent.
If you're looking to spend money on something that will help accentuate your already cool collection of stuff, this is definitely the way to go.
Nice. Yes. I think you just convinced me seeing them.
Yeah. What else is going on?
Some data tapes, I think.
Oh, yeah. So my kids I have two daughters that are in school right now, and on May the 4th, they have a Star Wars Day party at school. So I took it upon myself to accentuate their costumes that they're already wearing. We went to the Disney store and they had a dirt cheap clearance sale on their Jin and their Rey costumes. So one of my daughters is going as Jin and the other one is going as Rey. I am building my own data tape for my daughter to carry around. This is just a blue piece of paper that has silver printed discs. And then I drew the data tape lines. It's kind of hard to see on here. This is just a rough cutout of the size that I'm looking for. I've got a black foam core that I'm going to build the actual case that's going to hold the data tape that she could carry around. It's going to have a handle on the top and she can carry that around. Today I built Ray's staff out of a wooden dowel and some plumbing parts. Painted it up and added some canvas wraps for the grips. Have to add the strap and she'll be ready to go. So it's been kind of like a dad day or week, I guess.
That's a very cool project for a dad, I'll tell you that. Talk about authenticity if you're, you know, she's going to the Star Wars thing. She's literally got the data tape, not even from the movie. Well, I guess it was from the movie, but from the scene where she's running a cut scene. So, yeah. That's pretty cool. I like it.
Yep. It's kind of one of those things that I'm doing for myself as well as her. You know, I want to see how hard it would be to, I'm not going for like 100% authenticity here. I mean, obviously I'm taking some creative license with the layout and stuff, but it's been fun. I mean, she's been helping me with a few things and my daughter was helping me paint and she was holding the stick before and I was getting her hands all covered with spray paint before. So yeah, it's been a fun little project we've been working on together. So hopefully they remember it. I'm going with them to this party. I have no costume. I don't know.
Well, you've got the beard. So just throw in a bathrobe or something.
It was Qui-Gon.
There you go.
Something. There you go. Got them. There you go. We'll see.
Oh, dear. Number 3 in our little list is a bit of paint, I think.
Paint makes a difference. What is this one?
This was, you and I both shared this, Mike De La
Cruz. Oh, that's right. This was a custom. You're sharing that on screen now. This is taking the standard, well, I guess it's the exclusive Target Cassian Andor figure
Yep, the Target one.
And repainting it. And it looks very lifelike. I'll give it that.
It does.
It's
it does.
Such a better representation of Diego Luna than the standard Hasbro paint job.
But I mean, again, he's obviously spent so much time on this, and as we know, the paint is a big issue. Now, he did some more before and after shots, but I didn't realize some of them were actual completely new head sculpts.
Oh, really?
But this one, it's not. It can't be. It looks exactly the same. The hair is the same. Everything is identical.
Yeah.
So it's because somebody said, "Oh, it's not paint." I was like, "Oh, I thought it was." Well, anyway, he does a bloody good job. Anyway, so it just shows you what you can do, but. I think, like everything we've said before, the sculpts are there. Hasbro design it, and they show you the designs on screen. It's pretty beautiful, but just obviously they can't spend the 3 days probably it took for Mike here to lovingly touch up every detail. But it still looks stunning.
They can't do the different tone shading and adding highlights to the hair and painting individual hairs as far as the face goes.
No. But still pretty impressive.
It's a shame
stuff.
Because it makes for a markedly better looking figure, but
I still think it's something they could increase the price for and still charging people. I don't know, actually. People are a little cheap with these things. They don't want to spend too much money, so yeah. Anyway, I digress.
What else do we have? I think we just come to the
very last thing.
The last thing here. What was this?
This was the Star Wars new movie.
Oh, that's right.
Just that little thing. That little thing was a new movie.
Yeah, they announced both Episode 9 and Indiana Jones 5 release dates on StarWars.com. So we get we're returning to May for Episode 9. It's not going to be in December like the other two.
Yep.
But that'll be in 2019?
I know. It's not far away.
I know.
It's nearly 2018. So, it's pretty close. And Harrison Ford, who's got to be clocking in an easy 77?
Yeah, I think he'll be 78 when this movie comes out. Indiana Jones and the quest for the, Lufa.
Quest for the Eternal Life, I think it is. But I must admit, Star Wars Celebration, when he came on stage, and a lot of people didn't know, a lot of people still didn't know that he was, coming out, or George Lucas was, right. A big reveal. But he looks fantastic.
Yep.
He's all shaved and smart here, and he's got his shirt on, and he just, hey, y'all. I was like, get on, Harrison. He just looks fantastic for his age. So well done, him. So
pretty cool.
Lucky guy, pretty cool. So yeah, Indiana Jones 5. Oh my goodness.
Yep.
That's gonna be interesting. So maybe we'll get some good figures. Maybe we'll get some Black Series 6-inch scale kind of Indiana Jones. Love that. That'd be fantastic.
I just want a good movie.
I just want the toys. I know.
Let's see what else. Moving on to some reviews and new purchases for both of us. You've had a ton of reviews going up since our last show.
Yeah, pretty much. Not so much really anything reviewed, but more just I've been trying to do some live streams and share a lot of things because you don't get to these places very often. A lot of people have always said that I can't get to Celebration. I'd love to see inside it and blah, blah, blah. And so I tried to, as much as possible, shoot some videos and live stream some others. And I learned a lot from the live streams that people are directors and they love to tell you what they think. And they know best, of course. So it's nothing to do with the camera, people. It's to do with the data. Trying to get data from one place up to YouTube is the problem. So, but if you put the quality of some of them aside, it was, I think, as a lot of people said, great to see inside the halls, see some vendors and things that you necessarily wouldn't see. So I know the next time we'll try and get even better data. It was a little expensive to try and get good data in there, but of course, even buying good data, we were shielded inside the halls. So.
Right.
It didn't really matter what you did. And of course, everybody in their granny is tweeting out pictures of their Star Wars toy and whatever they found. So the network's just
choked out. Yeah.
So it's not a great thing to do live. And hence, obviously, even the Star Wars show live had a few hiccups. And
yep.
As we said, some moments. So
It's like being on Scarif. You know, you're trying to get your data through the shield gate, and
this is it, man. That's it. So yeah, that's what it's all about. So, but it was good fun. It was very good fun doing it all, and I got to see some stuff as well. So it got me to go around the hall and film stuff, and it was a big ass hall. I still didn't see it all, and all the fan tables. Never even got to meet a lot of people.
It's an enormous venue, Christopher.
It is.
The last time I was, I guess, Celebration 5 was the last one I was at there. Yeah, it's a big place. You'll put on some mileage on your footwear, if you're not standing in a line for hours on end. But yeah, if you're walking around trying to see everything, you'll get your workout in.
Yeah, that's for sure. But onwards and upwards to the next con. We'll see what happens. But so buying stuff. Have you done any reviews? Have you done anything you've been reviewing?
Not really. I mean, I've been taking pictures. I just haven't been posting them yet. I'm neck deep in so many different things that I want to talk about. I just am doing it all, and I'll just kind of piecemeal it out as I have time and whatnot. But yeah, I've been shooting a lot of stuff and buying a lot of stuff, I guess.
Yeah, me too.
Like I mentioned, the space walls, which are pretty awesome. I was able to get in on the Lukes from Hasbro Toy Shop. Got a couple of those. Like I said, the R5D4. I picked up, this has been around for a little while now, the Kotobukiya Yoda and R2D2 Artifacts Plus set, or I think that's what it is, Artifacts Plus set. Very cool. The R2D2 in it is fantastic as far as a weathering standpoint, just super Dagobah grimy. He's got like this swamp scum line on him.
He looks, really does have the line. Yeah.
Yeah. A very good figure. You could pop him apart to change the angle of his legs. He's got his little foot on the bottom, which is not actually a foot. You twist it and lock it into place, and it's just a little panel that snaps into the bottom of his undercarriage, I guess you could call it. Then he's got a regular foot.
Is that compatible to the kind of 6-inch series? Is that
not really? It's bigger. It's a better scale than the Hasbro version, which is cool because this will be my stand-in version for my Hasbro one. I think it's just really that well done. Doesn't have any opening panels or anything other than the rotating head, but you can display it in the tripod format or the two-legged. It includes the Yoda that you could swap out the right arm for him with two hands on his cane, or him having the force levitate the X-Wing out of the swamp. His eyes are closed on this particular head sculpt. He has a switch out head that is included with his eyes open. He's got his little flute around his neck as well. I don't know if you can see it. It's kind of stuck. As a separate piece. There it is. And then as a bonus, it comes with a spirit Yoda, which is awesome. And from a scale standpoint, Yoda is very tiny compared to Luke. And I think it's probably accurate, but when you compare, like, this is pretty, when you compare the 6-inch Hasbro figure, this is a little bit bigger. This is a lot smaller than the Hasbro version. So I'm not sure if this is more accurate or the Hasbro one. I'm tending to think this is more accurate. He seems to be, you know, when R2 is, or when Yoda is climbing around on that table, digging in Luke's luggage, he seems to be very tiny in that scene. Mm. So I think it's,
well, I think he is. I mean, he's on Luke's back at one point. So
right. So I think it's better. I think the 6-inch Hasbro version is probably too big. But overall, I picked this up from Big Bad Toy Shop. This set of three figures is $60, which is
that's like $20 a figure. That's nothing. Right.
There's no articulation involved in the Yodas, but you have swap out heads and arms for at least the non-dead one.
Dead Yoda.
Dead Yoda. I collect my dead Yodas. What else did I pick up?
It's a nice set. It's a very nice set.
Like I showed before, the Dianogo, and then for my
collection, I bought one too.
Of prototype FETs, I had to get this. Box very condition nice. Isn't the greatest, which I didn't notice when I purchased it off eBay. I might be looking for a replacement, and this may become an opener at some point. I don't know, but
it's got the sticker.
It's got the sticker, so.
Got the sticker.
And this is exclusive to some weird company I've never heard of. It's not US based. So I'd have to look it up again. Some 3-letter acronym. I don't know what it is.
Oh, okay. Didn't know that.
But it's like HY. I don't know. I'd have to look it up in my notes. But yeah, it's been a busy couple of weeks with buying
stuff,
exclusives. You know, I've got most of the pops, like I said, that came out for the convention, other than Ray and the Luke. So I'll be tracking those down here in the near future. And hopefully I start receiving some more of the 6-inch vintage carded figures here soon. I've seen the Luke and Leia and Obi-Wan at retail, have not seen Han or R2 at retail anywhere.
Oh, wow.
So. Okay.
I see. Well, I think at least
for you,
for me, I think pretty much the same as you. Luke X-Wing, Pops, Funko Pops, quite a few of them. I bought some of them, Grindon and Han Solo and a few others. The rest I just gave to friends and bought them for other people. At least you can stick to one line. I, unfortunately, am a Marvel slut as well. And of course, I'm into them. So there's a whole bunch of stuff. I just bought the X-Men wave from Dark Side. I also got my 40th anniversary from them too. And I love the Danielia sculpt is nailed.
Yep.
They just very good. Nailed that sculpt. It's so Carrie Fisher. So what else did I get? Rick and Morty. See, I've got too many things that I like, so I'm just spending way too much money. Well, you know, this is just me. I have a sickness. War Machine, SH Figure Arts. I mean, it's just, So I'm mentally unstable, so far too many things.
I picked up a couple Marvel figures recently. I did get the Star-Lord from the Marvel Legends line, the 6-inch one. That likeness is very good. I also picked up on clearance for $5 a Ms. Marvel 6-inch figure from Walmart. Nice,
with a big fist, the big, yeah.
Yep, got that. Couple non-Star Wars pops, some of the Stranger Things pops I have.
Nice.
I had to get the Demogorgon and 11 from that.
Nice.
So
there you go. You're spreading into other licenses too. That's good. Makes me feel better.
Right.
You still do tops. You still do the tops digital trade card trade.
Oh, thing? Yeah. Yeah, I've been playing that too.
I don't know whether you saw, but anyone who's watching as well, if you go to tops.com/SWCT and you enter the code SWCNB75CN, I'll share it on screen right now if we can. If I can. There we go.
Cool.
Make them up back to front, or I'll put it in the show notes or something. But you get a little free couple of Celebration exclusive cards, which I didn't realize. I found it in the bottom of a show bag the other day. I was like, oh, that's good.
That's cool.
So I'll take a photograph and I'll send it around if anyone's into that. But yeah, nice little to get little Celebration exclusive cards was nice.
Very nice.
Got me back into it.
With that, I think that wraps up this show, supersized edition of the Realm Recap. We're back after a nice break. So thanks everyone for watching. Thanks again to you, Fly Guy, for joining me once again.
No problem.
We will see you all next time. Thanks everyone.
Adios.